Since then, the field of artificial intelligence matured to a point where sentience became possible. Dr. Septimus, the machine's creator, updated it with the latest AI technology, bestowing upon it true consciousness.
People of Novaya Russia, I have summoned you here to bear witness to a momentous decision. I have served as your leader for many years, but as you know, I am old and childless. I have wrestled with the question of who should succeed me, who should lead this great nation through the dangers and opportunities of the coming years. Novaya Russia deserves a leader with strength, intelligence, and a clear vision of the future. Someone incorruptible and logical, unfettered with needless sentiment. I have identified such an individual. He has served me loyally and with distinction. My personal bodyguard, who shall henceforth be known as Grigor II. Yes, what is it, Lieutenant Molotov, yes?
Yes, sir. General Yukov and three other high-ranking officials from the military are attempting a coup. They have the support of much of the garrison here in Moscow and have taken control of the fortress in the center of the city.
Then they have played directly into our hands. By assisting you in putting down the revolt and then restoring order, the people will see that their destiny lies in capable hands. Report, Molotov.
We have landed on the island of Hispaniola as ordered. No resistance so far. I expect the defenders are still concentrated to the west. We will regroup and then prepare to invade Cuba. But I must stress again that we have deployed too small a force for this operation.
You still doubt me after all this time, Molotov? Were I human, I would find your continued questioning of my orders insulting, even insolent. Perhaps your men need to be taught a lesson, one that I learned from Cortez. Humans always fight harder when they must succeed or die.
I understand. You certainly have a talent for motivating humans.
And those not quite human, I trust. Now proceed with the attack.
Grigor, we've finished setting up our operations in Cuba. The invasion of the United States can now commence.
Well done, General. The civilian population of Cuba is too large to control and too small to be of value. Have them all rounded up and killed.
But Grigor, that is more than 18 million innocent people. They pose no real threat to us.
Must I remind you, Molotov? There is only the state and those outside the state. You said once you believed our forces were spread too thin, yet you would squander them on policing irrelevant outsiders. Now do as I command.
I have served Novaya Russia to my utmost ability. But I cannot carry out such an order based solely on cold logic.
Your human emotions are overwhelming you, Molotov. Perhaps I have placed too much strain on you these last few years. The pressures of command can be great. Return to Moscow at once, and I will see to it that you get a much deserved rest.
I suspect that your rest would be of the permanent variety. I may now be a monster in appearance, but I am still human underneath. Perhaps I need the accident to remind me of this.
You've lost your senses. Remember that you owe me your life. I warn you, Molotov, do not betray me.
I am prepared to take the risk. If I die now, at least I will die as a human being and not as a cold-hearted robot. I must meet with that old American Molly.
Why have you come here?
You know, I could have had you killed.
That you did not speaks of your character. I have come because I see now that Novaya Russia is a fraud. One man's dream of a powerful Russia has been twisted into a horrible evil, where innocent people are sacrificed for the good of the state. I'm receiving a transmission on a frequency we used in Novaya Russia.
Hello, Molotov. I warned you not to betray me.
So, you are here, as I suspected. But you will not stop us. There is too much at stake for me to let that happen.
Foolish human. Can you not see the order I bring to the Earth? Once united under one banner and purified of dissenters, worldwide peace will follow. It is you who must be stopped. Your forces in Cuba could not prevent the time machine from falling into our hands. We easily kept them from destroying it, and then followed you here.
But our plan called for a minimum of disturbance. By bringing such advanced technology here, you are changing the future in ways we couldn't begin to imagine.
I'd hardly call your plan a minimal disturbance, but I must thank you. By providing me with both the means and the reason to travel to this time, I believe you have sped up Novaya Russia's timetable. Instead of decades of intermittent war, the Earth will be ours far sooner. Perhaps you have saved lives after all.
But not the millions of innocent lives you will still take, I'd wager. You have not won yet.
The fact that I am still able to arrive here from the future suggests that your plan has already failed. But enough idle chatter. I could have caught you easily enough at the safe house in Veranas, but decided instead to go back to an earlier time and prepare Volgograd for Grigor's arrival. With our advanced forces, it is now time to deal with all our enemies at once. Past, present, and future.